So how you doing, my fellow DJs? This is DJ 730, and I'm doing this recording because this is part two. Like I said, so you can see the title is part two of DJ or VJ recording with DJing with videos. And you know, I was still having, after I did everything, problems with my videos that I had downloaded, and I was trying to figure out what was the issue. So I had to do some investigations. So I got in contact with Record Box, with Pioneer, you know, and I was emailing back and forth trying to figure out. So I send them a clip of my video, and then they told me, oh, you got the wrong codecs. So they send me the information about codecs and containers. And this is what you're supposed to also know, that if Pioneer gave you a better explanation, you wouldn't have problems with your videos. So for instance, I wrote it down. Let me open it up and you're gonna see this, and you could freeze it if you want to for a minute, and you're gonna see what says codec, which is H.264, MPEG-4, and MPEG-2. These are the codecs, or the encoder. Codecs is like the, you could say more like the language, the programming language that the software is gonna read. The extension is the container, what holds it. It's like a bucket, you know. So a container is like a bucket, and the codec is like what you put inside the bucket. It might be water, it might be ice, it might be soda. But if you don't have the proper codecs, and you pass that bucket to someone else, they might know what the bucket is, but the container, they don't understand what it is. So they're only going to understand these three, and they're going to understand these containers. So it's a combination of both. So usually M.264. It's gonna be an MPEG file or MPEG container. You might change it to something else, but this has to be there. Like, this is what I'm using now, H.264 with the container MPEG-4. So this is the combination that works perfect. You see it in a lot of videos. This is the combination they use. MKL, I think is what YouTube uses. So it might say MPEG-4, but the codecs, it's something else. So let me give you a better example of how to figure out if you're having problems with your videos. Okay, this is what you're gonna do. You're gonna download VLC media player. Okay, once you download this media player, you're gonna look for a video file. The video file you're having problems, you might want to separate it, and then you're gonna open it up. Doesn't matter. I'll open up this one. I'm gonna stop it. Okay, pause it. Now, what I wanna do is go to tools, go to codecs information, and here it's gonna tell me. This is a codec, this is the H.264, right? That's the codec. And the container is an MPEG-4, you know. Another description for MPEG-4 is AVC. Okay, but MPEG-4 is what you're gonna see most of the time. So this is how I know that my video is gonna work perfectly with Rekordbox. Resolution, this is a 480 video, 640 by 480. It's a small video. Again, a 1080p is the maximum size. You could do 4K, but 4K will not play properly. It might freeze. I have videos that are 4K. So let me bring up this video right now that I have here. And in this video, you're gonna see that I'm able to jump back and forward without a problem, without the video breaking up. You know, a lot of my videos are, let me go to my videos, are 4K, no problem whatsoever. And you can see that it's, let me just bring it back, slide it to the left. And again, this is a high resolution video. I do not recommend trying to play 4K video because you might have little hiccups even though the music is going to continue playing. Depending on how powerful your computer is, because the high resolution is more information. So you want to keep it to 1080p. You want to keep it to the recommendations they give you. And again, it's going to work. This is going to function. I've been DJing for now for about maybe 3 weeks. And I've been DJing with videos, which I love it because people like it a lot. And it works. It's entertaining for me, for the viewer. The videos work well. Again, you're trying to play 4K video. If your computer's powerful enough, it's going to play it, but it's going to have hiccups. And my recommendation is keep it to 1080p. And since nobody's going to be on top of the video anyways, you know, they're going to be able to view it and it's going to be fine enough. The video looks good. I believe this video is also encoded in 4K. But I had to bring down my settings. Anything that is 4K is going to force you to bring down the settings depending on your computer, how powerful it is, what it lets you do. Let's go to video. So here I have a medium, not the highest resolution. If I put it to the highest resolution, I might have issues. Let's play this video. Let's see if we have issues with it. And what happens is it starts like going crazy and blinking on the side. It's not a video. It's not something that you want to show you all. This one is playing really good. And again, I jump back forward in the video. Keep it to 1080p, H.264, MPEG 4, and you're not going to have a problem. Again, remember this. Your computer, the older it is, the harder it is, you know, because of the technology. But if your computer is recently new, it has enough video memory, you should be perfectly fine. You know, I'm able to boost my video card. I'm going to show you right now. My computer itself, this is the Predator Helios 300. I don't need that. You see here, my GPU, I could overclock it to extreme if I want. If I need more video power, I have control over my, my fan. So this is a really good computer. It's been really good to me. And I have souped up. But what I'm doing this video is for you to know that the software does work, the video does work really good, but you have to be careful when you download your videos and where you get your videos from. You have to understand the video format, you know, the codecs and the container. Videos are not like the music MP3 or AAC, the codecs is the name of the container. That's it. This is totally different. It's a different ball game. And again, I have a lot of videos because I was in a record pool. I downloaded some videos that I use to DJ with, all the new videos. You know, people are going to love the new stuff. It doesn't play 360 videos, so forget about that. But again, you're going to have videos. This is going to give you like 320, which is the lowest quality, so you can download the video the quickest. And because of the sitting position of the person who's watching the video, it might just look fine. But if you're downloading yourself the own videos from like YouTube or from wherever you're getting your videos, I suggest 1080p is, you know, it's what it tells you, recommends you. That's what you should download. With time, you know, CPU, GPU are gonna get better, more powerful, so 4K playback is gonna be easy, you know. But we're not quite there yet. to be playing that 4K video, you know. So my biggest suggestion is, don't kill yourself trying to have that 4K video like I did. Believe me, I have video that are 4K in resolution.
Mira, amor. Está bien que estamos en bacanería. Y aquí se vino a gozar.
Just too much information.
Y yo estoy claro. Y para los
mundos fue un tiro.
Will freeze a little bit if 1080p quality. Will freeze a little bit if you have that 4K. You have to push your video card. You know, especially when there's a lot of movement in the video and stuff like that. The video will freeze for a minute. The song will continue playing. But because I have the right Codec and the right container, I have no problem with going through gaps before the video. What else I wanted to share with you? Okay, so like I have this software is the software that I use. If I download a video, this is the software I use to transform the video. So you see my output MPEG-4, that's my Codec, and my container, my not my Codec, my container and my Codec is MPEG-H264. That's my Codec, and my container is MPEG-4. So I have it highest quality, largest file, sound quality, the highest quality, you know. And what I love about this, I declared my folder where it's gonna save my files to. So I have a folder where I download my stuff to, then it saves it to, and I also have it set up. So let's go output. Okay, and options. That's what I love about this software. Conversion. See, it has the option to delete source file after converting. So after convert the file, it does everything of the conversion. It'll delete the original. I don't have to go manually deleting anything. It'll do it for me. So thank you. Thank you very much, software. It works well. I am going to post also information where you could write to Pioneer. You need to get in contact with the software. Let them know what's going on. Let them know what you're thinking about. You know, because the problem is that if you write to them, they're gonna start second guessing on what the DJ needs. And for instance, video. This right here, forget about video, but this right here, I think they should move it over here. It should have been over here. So I could just go scroll up right here. I don't know why I have to go all the way over here to do that. You know, there's certain little things that they could improve. You know, you can't really, well, in this version at least, you can't mix video and music in the autoplay. You know, it would've been cool if you could just drop your videos or your regular song file or make a playlist with both. But you can if you play the song out here, and I'm assuming you most probably you can, because this one, actually it moved some of my videos that I played, you know, playlist. And your playlist, I believe you could mix both of them, but again, you have to be careful. Workbox is a great software, so it lets you do a lot of things, but again, if you're using it to VJ, to play video, you must understand what I explained to you. Videos are different. They have a Codec and they have a container. And you have to have the proper combination. Okay, if my explanation is not good enough, I am going to put a link to someone who has a video on YouTube, which explains to it perfectly. So down on the bottom, it's gonna be a link with all the information you need. Also, if you need to contact Recordbox. So this is the link for Recordbox support on the top. See right here. And I'm gonna post it so you can just click on it on my intro thing. In the bottom should be there. and this is YouTube video that you should watch that gives you an even better explanation about codecs and containers. Okay, remember resolution 1080p, the maximum. So 1920 by 1080, okay? And your audio is only gonna be AAC or MP3. So this is just a quick video. Do not cancel. Do not put it away. So again, you can see that the video is working. Video wise, it's good. You're able to play video. It does work. I mean, I've been DJing with it. I've been playing for hours. So I do about 7 hours of, you know, playing music and videos without a problem. I hope you enjoy this video. Give a like, share it with other people, share the information. You know, hopefully they'll change their mind and we could just buy what we need from the software and get back on the boat. It's a great software. Lets you do a lot of stuff. It lets you link, like I said in my other stuff, it lets you link videos to your regular MP3 songs. It lets you do slideshows. I mean, it's a great software. So this is DJ 730 signing out. Peace.